Hi, I'm David Dodge. Welcome to Green Energy Futures. Kevin Maw is an environment reporter for the St. Albert Gazette. He just might be the longest standing environment reporter in the Edmonton region. He's written about and wanted to buy an electric vehicle since 2007. But for Kevin, the seed was planted even earlier when he was doing stories on the state of watersheds.
When you start looking into water, of course, inevitably you start realizing, hey, climate change is influencing it. And it was kind of like you spend all summer long climbing this massive steep hill and you get to the top of it and you see there's this giant mountain behind it called climate change. And I was like, oh, I don't want to go into this. But then I realized, hey, wait a minute. No, this is an even bigger topic and I should probably look into it.
Kevin embraced water issues and even did a master's thesis on it, but once he opened the climate change door, there was no turning back.
Really, it all boils down to two things. One's economics, and the second is energy. If you solve where you're getting your energy from, if you get your energy from renewable sources that don't rely on fossil fuels, you have entirely solved the problem of global heating and runaway climate change.
Kevin learned from Environment Canada that about two-thirds of our energy use in the home is for air and water heating. And the next biggest slice is transportation. Our cars.
Okay, what are different ways that I can help my readers understand what they can do about climate change? And inevitably, they all came back to energy. Things like re-insulating your home, energy efficiency, getting more efficient transportation, electrification, since electricity is much easier to get from a green source than pretty much any other form of energy out there.
Kevin was not only writing about these things, he took action in his own life.
Okay, what's the most efficient way I can do it? Most efficient form of transportation I can get? Electric car. Bam, well, let's go that. Go get that. I go to the market and I'm like, okay, the only one on the market right now, this is 2007, is the Tesla. Okay, yep, see you later. And so at that time I did research. Okay, I can't afford a Tesla. Let's get a Honda Civic Hybrid.
But Kevin didn't give up. And 10 years later, a more affordable long-range all-electric vehicle appeared in the form of the Chevy Bolt. With a B. Kevin did his homework. He used his car for work and needed a car with at least 300 kilometer range. Teslas were still expensive, so that left the Chevy Bolt with 400 kilometers of range.
If you just want a car that goes and saves you money and doesn't destroy the planet every time you start it up, go for anything else. Like, for me, the Bolt was the right choice. Well, I've only had it for 6 months so far, but basically, what I've noticed is in summer weather, the top range, the way I drive it, seems to be about 500 clicks.
Kevin says you lose about 25% range in the winter, and he gets about 100 kilometers of range charging his Bolt in a 120 outlet at his condo overnight.
If you're charging this thing every night, it's virtually impossible you're going to run out of juice. And even if you do, now, in many locations, there are ways you can charge these things in the field.
So I asked Kevin, how's it going driving an EV?
It accelerates so quickly that I have to be kind of cautious with the accelerators, otherwise I end up breaking the speed limit. It handles like a dream, incredibly small turning radius, starts up instantly in the winter. It's incredibly cheap, and the thing that really pushed me towards the electric vehicle was not just the cheapness, is because with the electric vehicle, you can actually have a true zero-emission vehicle.
It wasn't long after Kevin Maw spent time on the environment beat that he decided there was an electric vehicle in his future. Learn more and see photos at greenenergyfutures.ca. For Green Energy Futures, I'm David Dodge.